हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ रुचि कौशिक शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, बाबू बनारसी दास, नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, लखनऊ. सो वी हैव लर्न अ लॉट अबाउट मैट्रिसेस इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर. वी हैव लर्न हाउ टू फाइंड आइगन वैल्यूज एंड आइगन वैक्टर ऑफ ए मैट्रिक्स, ऑफ ए स्क्वायर मैट्रिक्स इनफैक्ट. सो नाउ वी हैव application of eigenvalue and eigenvector. With the help of eigenvalues and eigenvector, we can diagonalize a matrix. So the meaning of diagonalization is we have to convert a given square matrix into a similar diagonal matrix. So first of all, we have to know what is similarity. So we have two matrices A and B. A and B both are the square matrix. So A is a n cross n matrix, B is also n cross n matrix. So the number of rows and number of columns in A is equals to n, and number of rows and number of columns in B also n. So these two are square matrix. So now these two matrix are said to be similar if there exists a matrix P which is a invertible matrix. The determinant of P is not equal to 0, then we can define a similarity transformation between A and B such that B is equals to P inverse AP. So then A and B are said to be similar matrices. So, with the help of similarity, we can study various properties of matrices which are similar for similar matrices. So, next definition is diagonalization. Suppose we have a matrix A which is also a square matrix, and we want to diagonalize it, or we want to reduce it to a diagonal matrix D. So, first of all, we have to find a matrix P. For finding P, we have to calculate eigenvectors for given matrix A, or we can say we have to find linearly independent eigenvectors. So, as we know, if we have a matrix A which is a square matrix, so we have to write A minus lambda I and we should put determinant of A minus lambda I is equals to 0. Then with the help of this, we can find characteristic equation of the given matrix A, and we can calculate all the eigenvalues and with the help of these eigenvalues we have to calculate eigenvectors. So, corresponding to each eigenvalue we should find eigenvector, and from these eigenvectors we have to collect all the Li eigenvectors, all the linearly independent eigenvectors. So, if the eigenvectors are linearly independent, then the given matrix is diagonalizable. Okay? So, now we have a 2 by 2 cross 2 cross 2 matrix A. We have to calculate matrix P. So, first of all we have to write A minus lambda I is equals to 0. So, 4 minus lambda 1, 2, 3 minus lambda equal to 0. So, we can write 4 minus lambda, 3 minus lambda minus 2 equal to 0. we can write 7 lambda plus lambda square minus 2 equal to 0. So, lambda square minus 7 lambda plus 10 equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation and we know how to solve a quadratic equation. So, lambda square minus 5 lambda minus 2 lambda plus 10 is equals to 0. So, lambda is common, lambda minus 5 minus 2 common, lambda minus 5 equal to 0, lambda minus 2, lambda minus 5 equal to 0, lambda equal to 2 comma 5. These two are the eigenvalues for the given matrix A. Now, corresponding to each eigenvalue, we have to find eigenvectors. So, let's start. So, first of all, for lambda equal to 2. So, we can write A x equal to lambda x by the definition of eigenvalue and eigenvectors. So, you can write in this form 4 minus 2 is 2, 1, 2, 3 minus 2 is 1, x 1 x 2 equal to 0, 0. You know A minus lambda I x equal to 0. So, now we get two homogeneous equations 2x1 plus x2 equal to 0 and other equation also same. So, two unknown and one equation. So, we will get infinite many solutions and we can write x1 equals to minus 1 upon 2x2. Suppose I am giving value x2 equal to minus 2, then x1 will be 1. So, from here we have a eigenvector 1 minus 2. And now we have to find other eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 5. So, that will be now, I have lambda is equals to 5. So, I can write in this form 4 minus 5 is minus 1, 1, 2 minus 2, x1, x2 equal to 0, 0. Then again we have two homogeneous equations, both of these is equals. So, x1 equal to x2, suppose it is equals to 1. So, this is x1. Now, we have x2 which is equals to 1, 1. So, with the help of these eigenvectors, I can write this matrix P which is equals to 1 minus 2, 1, 1. Now, we want to calculate this P inverse and as we know, if we have a 2 by 2 matrix, then by interchanging diagonal positions and multiplying by minus of off diagonal entries, we will get inverse of the matrix and we have to divide it by its determinant. So, you can check 1 plus 2 is equals to 3. So, 1 upon determinant and this is adjoint of P, which is equals to minus 1, 2. So, it is the inverse of the matrix P. Now, with the help of P, we can find matrix D. So, P inverse AP is equals to 1 upon 3, 1 minus 1, 2, 1. A is 4, 1, 2, 3, then P 1 minus 2, 1, 1. Now we get 1 upon 3, 1, 2 minus 1, 1, and multiplying these two matrices, 4 minus 2 is 2, 4 plus 1 is 5, 2 minus 6 is minus 4, 2 plus 3 is 5. You can check. 4 minus 2 is 2, 4 plus 1 5, 2 minus 6 is minus 4 and 5. Now, we can multiply these two matrices, 2 plus 4 is 6, 5 minus 5 0, 4 minus 4 0, 10 plus 5 15, which is equals to, this is 1 upon 3. You can divide each and every entry of the matrix. So, we will get 2, 0, 0, 5, which is equals to a diagonal matrix. So, by this process, you can see the matrix A is similar to the diagonal matrix D. So, this is the diagonalization process, and with the help of eigenvectors, first of all, you have to write the matrix P. Then you have to calculate the inverse of this matrix P, and then by the definition of similarity, you have to calculate D is equals to P inverse AP. So, I hope all of you understand very clearly this concept. So, we are coming to application of diagonalization. if we are able to diagonalize a given square matrix, then we can find powers of that matrix in this way. Suppose you have a matrix A which is diagonalizable, then first of all you have to calculate D, and now you want to find what will be the AN. N may be 100. So, suppose you want to find A raised to power 100. Suppose in this example, so, by pre-multiplying P, we will get curl 2, this is become I, A and P. Now, by post-multiplying by P inverse, you will get A n. Now, just putting this power, suppose we have this matrix, this one. And now, I want to calculate A raised to power 100. So, just calculate D raised to power 100, which is very easy. Just putting powers on the diagonal entries, you will get the D raised to power 100, and by multiplying P and P inverse you can find A raised to power 100. So, this is a application of diagonalization. This is an example for calculating m raised to power 6, or we can write it A because we are using the notation A for square matrix. So, suppose we have this A is equals to 1 1 minus 2 4. Now, first of all you have to write A minus lambda I and again repeat the same procedure for calculating its eigenvalues, eigenvectors. With the help of eigenvectors you have to write the matrix P, then P inverse, and with the help of P and P inverse we can calculate the diagonal matrix D, which is equals to P inverse AP. So, you can solve easily. So, first of all we have to calculate the determinant A minus lambda I 1 minus lambda 1 minus 2 4 minus lambda is equals to 0, 1 minus lambda 4 minus lambda plus 2 equal to 0. So, you can calculate the eigenvalues lambda minus 3, lambda minus 2 equal to 0. Okay. So, eigenvalues will be 2 comma 3. Now, with corresponding to eigenvalue 2 you have to find x 1, corresponding to eigenvalue 3 you have to calculate x 2. Eigenvectors corresponding to these eigenvalues. So, we can calculate easily A minus lambda I. So, A minus 2i. So, 1 minus 2, 1 minus 4 minus 2, 4 minus 2, x 1 x 2 equal to 0 0. So, it will be minus 1 1 minus 2 2 x 1 x 2 equals to 0 0 minus x 1 plus x 2 equal to 0 minus 2 x 1 plus 2 x 2 equal to 0. Now, you can say what will be x 1, which is equals to 1 1. Here x 1 equal to x 2. So, it is a one eigenvector. As you know there exists infinite number of eigenvectors, but we are choosing only one eigenvector, which is Li eigenvectors. Now, for lambda equal to, I can write here also, for lambda equal to 3, first of all you have to write 1 minus 3 is minus 2, 1 minus 2 and 4 minus 3 is 1, x 1 x 2 which is equals to 0 0. So, from here you will get 2 x 1 equal to x 2. So, suppose I am choosing x 1 is 1. So, x 2 will be 2. This is another eigenvector. So, with the help of these eigenvectors we can write the matrix P. The first column of P will be 1 1 and second column will be 1 2. So, we have P is equals to 1 1 1 2. Now, we have to calculate P inverse, which is equals to 2 minus 1 is 1, 2 1 minus 1 minus 1, this is P inverse. Now, we want to calculate D is equals to P inverse AP equal to 2 minus 1 minus 1 1, A is 1 minus 2 1 4, 1 minus 2 1 4, then write 1 1 1 2 is equals to 2 minus 1 minus 1 1, 1 plus 1 2, 1 plus 2 3, minus 2 plus 4 2, minus 2 plus 8 is 6, which is equals to 4 minus 2 is 2, 6 minus 6 0, minus 2 plus 2 0, minus 3 plus 6 3. So, this is a diagonal matrix. Now we have to calculate A raised to power 6. So, for that A raised to power 6 is equals to P D raised to power 6 P inverse. Now, just putting all these values and multiplying the matrices, you will get the A raised to power 6. And all of you know how to multiply given matrices. So, 2 raised to power 6 will be 64 0 0 7 29 I think 2 minus 1 minus 1 1. Now, multiply all these and you will get the A raised to power 6. So, now I am very confident that all of you can multiply all these matrices and find A raised to power 6. This is your homework. Now I am giving a square matrix A which is of order 3 by 3 and you have to calculate the fourth power of the given matrix A. So, here we have 3 cross 3 matrix. And we want to find A raised to power 4. Okay. So, for 2 by 2, we have calculated 2 examples. Then, now we have the clear concept in our mind how to calculate eigenvalues, eigenvectors for the given matrix, and with the help of eigenvectors, we can form the matrix P. Here, the matrix P will be of order 3 by 3 and then you have to calculate inverse of this matrix and then you have to multiply P inverse AP and you will get the diagonal matrix D. Okay, let's start. So, first of all, we have to write A minus lambda I equal to 0. So, 1 minus lambda 0 minus 1, it should be in determinant form. So, we have to write a determinant here. 1 2 minus lambda 1 2 2 3 minus lambda is equals to 0. Now, you can use this formula for calculating the characteristic polynomial, that is equals to for 3 by 3 matrix lambda cube minus trace of A into lambda square plus the minors of diagonal to lambda minus determinant of A is equals to 0. You can use this formula, but I am writing directly what will be the characteristic polynomial for the given matrix. So, we can write 1 minus lambda and with that 2 minus lambda 3 minus lambda minus 2 minus 0, and we are not bother about the quantity, whatever it will be, it multiplied with 0 will become 0. So, next is minus 1, and we have to write 2 minus lambda. So, now we can write which is equals to 0, 1 minus lambda, 2 minus lambda, 3 minus lambda minus 2, 1 minus lambda. Now, we can see here, it will be, if we take minus sign is out, then we will get 2 lambda minus 2, that will be plus 2 times 1 minus lambda. Okay? Which is equals to 0. Now, these two are cancel out. Then we will get 3 eigenvalues, which is lambda is equals to 1, comma 2, comma 3. By putting these factors equal to 0, then we will get lambda is equals to 1, lambda is equals to 2, and lambda is equals to 3. So, now corresponding to all these eigenvalues, we have to calculate eigenvectors. So, for that we know A x is equals to lambda x, then A minus lambda I x equal to 0. So, we have to write here A minus, since lambda is 1. So, I can write 1 here also, 1, and this is A minus I x equal to 0. So, in this matrix we can put 1. So, we will get 0, 0 minus 1, 0, 0 minus 1. Next one will be 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Third row will be 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, and you have to write x 1, x 2, x 3, which is equals to 0, 0, 0. Now, we have to write all the homogeneous equations for the given system. So, 0 x 1 plus 0 x 2 minus x 3, 0 x 1 plus 0 x 2 minus x 3 equal to 0. So, next will be x 1 plus x 2 plus x 3 equal to 0, 2 x 1 plus 2 x 2 plus 2 x 3 is equals to 0. So, from first equation you can see we are not having x 1 and x 2 in this equation. This equation gives only x 3 is equals to 0. By putting x 3 equal to 0 in the second equation, we will get x 1 is equals to minus x 2. So, with the help of all these equations, the third equation is similar to the second one. So, we have these two equations, and then with the help of these equations, we can write if x 1 is 1, then x 2 will be minus 1 and x 3 is 0. This is the first eigenvector. Now, we have to calculate eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda is equals to 2. So, again we have to write A minus, here we have A minus 2 I x equal to 0. So, A minus 2, this is A minus 1. So, we can write minus 1, this will be 0 and this will be 1, 0 minus 1, 1, 1, and these will be same, x 1, x 2, x 3 equal to 0, 0, 0. Now minus x1 plus 0x2 minus x3 equal to 0 and x1 plus 0x2 plus x3 equal to 0. These two are same equations. Then third one will be 2x1 plus 2x2 plus x3 equal to 0. So, from these two equations we have x1 is equals to x3. So, suppose x1 is equals to x3 in, and we put this in third equation, we will get, no, x1 is equals to minus x3. We have to put x1 is equals to minus x3. So, from this equation we can put 2x1 plus 2x2 minus x1. Then we will get x1 plus 2x2 equal to 0. So, we have relation, first one is x1 equal to minus x3 and second one is x1 equal to minus 2x2. Suppose we are giving value 2 to x1, then x2 will be minus 1, x3 will be minus 2. This is the other eigenvector. So, in the same way, now we have to calculate what will be the x3. So, suppose we have now lambda is equals to suppose we have now lambda equal to 3. So, we will have minus 2, 0, minus 1, 1, minus 1. Now, with the help of these eigenvalues, the eigenvalues are 1 minus lambda, 2 minus lambda, 3 minus lambda equal to 0. So, we will get lambda is equals to 1, comma 2, comma 3. So, corresponding to all these eigenvalues, we have to write eigenvectors. So, first of all, lambda is equals to 1. So, with the help of this equation, Ax equals to lambda x, we can write A minus lambda I x equal to 0. So, what is A minus lambda I? It is 1 minus lambda, 2 minus lambda, 3 minus lambda, 1 minus lambda, 2 minus lambda, 3 minus lambda and here 0 minus 1 1, 0 minus 1 1. 1 2 2 1 2 2 and it is x1 x2 x3 equal to 0 0 0. So, first of all, for lambda is equals to 1, we can write 0 0 minus 1 1 1 1 2 2 2 and it is x1 x2 x3 equal to 0 0 0. So by this system we will get 3 homogeneous equations. So there will be 0x1 plus 0x2 minus x3, then we will get x3 is equals to 0, and these two equations will be same, x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to 0, 2 common, x1 plus x2 plus x3 will be 0. So second equation will be x1 plus x2 plus x3 is equals to 0. So by putting x3 is equals to 0, we will get x1 is equals to minus x2. So we can give x1 is equals to 1, then x2 will be minus 1, x3 is 0. So we will get the first eigenvector will be 1 minus 1 0. Okay. Now in similar way we can calculate second eigenvector corresponding to lambda is equals to 2. For lambda equal to 2, we have 1 minus 2 minus 1 0 minus 1, this will be 1 0 1 and next one 2 2 1. Here x1 x2 x3 is equals to 0 0 0. So again we can write in homogeneous equation form, minus x1 plus 0x2 minus x3 equal to 0, next one 1 plus 0 x2 plus x3 equal to 0. From these two equations we will get x1 equal to minus x3, and third one will be 2 x1 plus 2 x2 plus x3 equal to 0. Now you can put x3 equal to minus x1, and 2 x1 minus x1 will be x1 plus 2 x2 equal to 0. Now we can write x1 equal to minus 2 x2. So value of x1 will be, suppose it is equals to minus 2, then x2 will be 1 and x3 become 2. So again we will get x2 is equals to minus 2 1 2. Now we have to calculate, we got 2 eigenvectors. Now the third eigenvector for lambda equal to 3, again we have to repeat the process. So we can write lambda equal to 3, and by putting the value for lambda, 1 minus 3 will be minus 2, this will be same, 0 minus 1, here 1, 2 minus 3 is minus 1, then by putting value for lambda it will be 0. So for this system we have 3 homogeneous equations, minus 2x1 plus 0x2 minus x3 equal to 0, x1 minus x2 plus x3 equal to 0, 2x1 plus 2x2 plus 0x3 equal to 0. So, here for first equation we have 2x1 equal to minus x3. Now, put this value in this equation. By putting x3 equal to minus 2x1, we will get minus x2 minus x1 equal to 0. So, x1 will equal to minus x2. So, we can write the third eigenvector will be for this system. The third eigenvector will be, if suppose we are putting x1 is equals to minus 1. So, x2 will be plus 1 and x3 will be 2. So, we will get x3 equal to minus 1, 1, 2. So, now we have all the three eigenvectors, and with the help of all three eigenvectors we can write the matrix P. The invertible matrix P will be, the first column of this matrix is x1 1 minus 1 0, second column will be minus 2 1 2, and third will be minus 1 1 2. Now, as we know the diagonalization process, so first of all we have to calculate the inverse of this matrix P. So, P inverse, as we know the formula for inverse, P inverse is equals to 1 upon determinant of P multiplied by adjoint of P. So, by using this formula we can calculate P inverse, and P inverse will be this. And after calculating P inverse we can use the formula P inverse AP, and we can see it become a diagonal matrix, and the entries on diagonal will be 1, 2 and 3, and now we have to calculate A raised to power 4. So, by calculating D raised to power 4, so D raised to power 4 will be 1 raised to power 4, 0, 0, 0, 2 raised to power 4, 0, 0, 0, 3 raised to power 4, and by multiplying with P and P inverse we will get the matrix this. So, this will be the A raised to power 4. So, this is a very useful process for calculating powers of a matrix. So, after finishing all the concept of eigenvalues, eigenvectors, Cayley-Hamilton theorem and this diagonalization process, all of you should understand all these points. First of all, you should understand that the meaning of eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and you, now all of you are able to calculate how to find eigenvalues, eigenvectors for 2 by 2 matrix, for 3 by 3 matrices. And second one is, you have to understand what is the characteristic matrix, what is the characteristic polynomial, what is the characteristic equation, and with the help of these equations you can find eigenvectors, eigenvalues also. So, last one point will be, you should understand that every 2 by 2 and 3 by 3 matrix satisfy its own characteristic equation. that is the Cayley-Hamilton theorem. So, I hope you are very much clear about all these points. So, hopefully this lecture is very helpful for all of you, and if you have any queries, then you can mail me on my email ID, that is ruchikaushik07@bbdnitm.ac.in. Thank you very much and all the best.